earlier video lecture, we have studied about the digital image processing, some points of the digital image processing. In that video, we have studied about the quantization, sampling, representation of image and all. So, we are going to start the basic of this image processing by understanding the visual perception. What is the meaning of visual perception is what we are going to understand in this video lecture. So, if we think about creating an image, how human eye is responsible for producing any image, how human eye can watch the image, okay? It is totally based on the visual perception of human eye. So, here in this video lecture, we are going to see about the anatomical structure of human eye and what exactly is there inside the human eye which is responsible for creating an image and how that image is going to get converted into an electrical signal and how brain recognizes that image is what we are going to understand in this video lecture. So, we are going to start the discussion in visual perception and anatomical structure of human eye. This is the thing called the human eyeball and it is the structure of a human eye. In this structure, first we have to see about what kind of things are there inside that eye. So, first we have a cornea which is the outer area of the eyeball. Then, if we look out here into the inside area where we have an iris there, which iris is what very important thing present inside your human eye, which is responsible for controlling the light intensity which is going to enter inside the human eye. So, ultimately, light intensity is what they control by using the iris. Now, iris used to contract and relax. Contract and relax in the sense it used to change its diameter. By changing the diameter, it is going to control the light intensity which is going to enter into your human eye. Okay. So, how it used to control the iris opening and closing, it is depend on the light intensity. Okay. In a low light, maybe when we used to watch the thing in the night, light condition is not that much good. So, at that time, iris is what very big. Why? Because outer light intensity is what not that much high. If you are looking into a sun, the light intensity is very high. At that time, your eyes is going to get in a small size. Okay, so light intensity is what going to get decreased that time. So it is ultimately going to get control for the light intensity. And who is to control that? Suspensory ligaments. Inside your human eye, we have a suspensory ligaments which is responsible for contracting and increasing and decreasing the opening of that iris. Okay, so what is the size of the iris? Maximum size of the iris opening is 2.8 mm. Is what we can open the iris to 2.8 mm. Okay, then this section have anterior chamber aqueous humor. In fact, we have aqueous humor. It is what we are going to say, right? After that, this plays very important role, that is nothing but the lens. Okay, so whenever light going to be there on your eye, that light is not going to enter through this iris and iris is going to open and change its circumference. When we get body, its opening is not going to get changed according to the light condition. Now, this light is not going to enter into a human eye. What we have inside the human eye, this is eyeball. Inside that eyeball, we have at the center point, at this point, we can call it a blind spot. Okay, so this is nothing but the blind spot. After that, this total area of the eyeball is called as the retina. On this retina, we have with this retina we have inner sclera and fovea. What is fovea? Fovea is located here on a retina, which consists which is responsible for colored image. Colored image in the sense on the fovea we have their cones. Okay, we are going to discuss about cones and what, but you just have to know that a fovea consists of the cone cells. So cone cells are located on a fovea. Okay, and the remaining area of the retina is what we cover with the rods. Okay, so in your human eye there are two different, it consists with the two different sensory cells. It consists with two sensory cells, or we can call it as a color sensor, that is nothing but the experience of our own sins. And if we think about the gods, they have much amount of a number as compared to bones, because their population is 75 to 150 million. So population wise, gods have larger strength there, larger population there as compared to bones. So 6 million to 7 million bone cells are there, which is activated in a light condition. Remember, we used to watch anything in a daylight. Okay, so light and brightness is not high. At that condition, bones are activated. It doesn't mean that rods are not activated at that condition, but bones need a bright light, nice light condition to create the color image. Why color image? Because bones are responsible for providing photopic vision, and it is responsible for color image. So whatever color you are watching by your human eye is what ultimately developed by using a cone cells, which is located on a fovea, that is on this side. Okay, at this side on a fovea, the cones are located. After that, what about a dim light condition? When we don't have that much light, maybe we used to travel in the night on a bike, maybe we are entering into a dark room. At that time, your eyes used to increase its opening, and much light intensity is what needed to your eye. At that condition, your color blindness is there. In a dark room, we can't find out the exact colors in that dark condition. So, at that time, which type of a sensory nerve used to activate it? This sensory nerve is the activated condition, that is nothing but a rods. Why? The population of the rods is 75 to 150 million. Its number is not very high. Okay, so it activated in a low light condition. Whatever the light condition is there, at that light condition, it used to get activated to provide us the vision. Okay, and the vision is what they created by using a rod is called as a photopic vision. Okay, and scotopic vision is what we have in the body, and it is responsible for black and white image. Cones are responsible for color image, and your rods are responsible for black and white image. Okay, so vision is what get created and activated, or when image is what get created, vision is what get created by using a cones is called as a photopic vision. And the vision is what get created, or vision is what they are responsible because of the rods, is what called as a scotopic vision. Okay, so photopic and scotopic vision is totally depend on the cones and rod. So in this video, we have discussed about the visual perception of human eye. It's a very basic video and basic structure of the human eye and sensory cells available inside human eye, that is rods and cones, is what we have discussed in this video. Thanks for watching this video. In next video, we are going to start a discussion with the distance measure and a pixel level.